Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ Chen Design Channel. Today we want to talk about is making our fifth text ring. You can find the first four in the description below. I will put a link over there, but this is the ring we're going to make today. Are you ready? Let's get started. The idea of making this ring is actually we are going to make a signal ring, or almost same idea with signal ring, and having the edge follow the text that we have here. We're gonna starting from the front view. Let's make a ring shank first. So type in 0. I like to set the diameter for 16 for most of my demonstration. So let's take a look at the front view. I'm going to use the command is arc and make sure my grid snap is on. It's up to you like how thick you want it to have a ring, but I want it to have a little bit thinner on the bottom and thicker on the side. Then let's go to the top view. We're going to type a text. I'm simply just going to use Rhino. You can use most of every text that you want, but I want it to be more fun on it. So I'm going to find if I can find any script. There's one that's called script empty bolt. Yeah, that was the one that I used. I will continue to use this one for the demonstration. I'm going to make it a little bit shorter, maybe like 6 millimeter high. It is already bolt, so that's what we're looking for. Make sure that you want to use curve instead of the surface or solid. Okay, so we have this text right. You can put it anywhere. And since it's grouped together, I'm going to use the align tool and align to the center, and let's just type it 0. So the text will be right in the center of my ring. All right, so now we have this over there. Let me move it to the top and I'll change the color to the black color. Okay, so now we have this. We need to see the border of it. You have two ways to do it. You can offset the distance on each of the text and try to join them together. And since I want it to be really, really smooth, and I'm just going to hand drawing. So make sure you cancel the grid snap and cancel, disable the old snap, so it's not snapping anywhere. So let's go ahead to giving an outline. We want to manually to make sure it almost has the same distance, but you don't want to go into very deep like that. You just want a general outline over there, because the more deep that you have, the crazier surfaces you're going to get. So I want to get something like really smooth and round over here. And you can always change it later on, so I just want to give a general outline there. And make sure at the very last one, our all snap is on, and we want to snap it into the endpoint. All right, so take a look on what you have. You can continue edit it until you feel like this is what you're looking for. Okay, so for the demonstration purpose, I'm going to stop it here. Otherwise, it's going to take too long for you to finish this video. Okay, so now we have this. Let's take a look on all four view. This one is currently on the construction plane, so I'm going to pick up that one. In our text, let's use the align tool, align to the top, and that's snapping into the top right there. Okay, so on the top view, it depends on like what shape of the ring you want. Maybe this overall is a little bit too big, so you can kind of scale it down if you want to. Now let's take a look on the top view. We are going to have a curve from here going to the edge, which is the red line over there. I'm going to use the command extend the curve. You have the arc to the point. So we are going to extend it from here and we want to snap it into the point close to very edge of the red line we have. We may not snap it directly to the construction plane, but that's okay. We have this curve right there. Let's take a look on all four view. You kind of notice that the end of our curve is actually snapping into this point right there. And that is not exactly on the construction plan, as you can see something like this. And it won't look good when we try to creating the surface. So we're coming back to the front view and use the command project to C plane. which is the construction plan. And we hit yes, we want to delete the input, even though it's not touching, but at least it's on the construction plan now. So to do the sweep 2, we need to have two rail, and we only have one curve here. So let's go ahead to use the split command, and we want to split with the point, and let's go into the quadrant. So now we have two rail over there. Okay, let me do one thing first, and that's showing you what I would like to change there. If we just go ahead to use the sweep 2, let's do rail 1, rail 2, cross section, and it will go all the way to the end. Okay, all right, it looked like not too bad there, but notice that your ring on the bottom is not nice and round, it's kind of coming to the point. Right, so it doesn't look too good. I actually want to have my button is more nice and smooth, more like a half round over there. So what I'm going to do is I wanted to create another cross section, so that's using the ellipse. We are going to do one more time the same command with sweep 2, rail 1 rail 2, cross section, and we're gonna coming back to our option, click on the point, and snapping into the endpoint or the quadrant. Alright, so this is what we have. Make sure that we want to align all the arrow and the direction as well, and they are facing the same direction. Let's click OK. Then you will get this shape over here. If you turn on the history and then you click OK, and we can kind of, if you, we feel like, okay, the middle part is a little bit too fat, and I want them to come in a little bit, then you are kind of able to do additional edit there. Notice that it follows the H really well over there. So I'm going to use the CAD command to close it. It will tell us that we're going to lose the history, which is fine because I'm not going to edit anymore. Okay, so let's take a look on the front view. We're going to pick up the ring size that we have. Let's go to the solid, extrude the planar curve straight. And we can simply just using the boolean difference tool and difference this out of that. Okay, so now we got a ring, it's follow the outline that we want. And we just need to pick up the text that we have. And let's go ahead to use the extruded planar curve again. This time we want to extrude it this way. Okay, so you can keep it like this if you like, or you want the text to be recessed. We can use boolean difference this out of the text that we just extruded out. All right, so that will be the ring that we have. Let's take a look on the render view. Right there. I hope you liked the video. Please comment, like, and if you are the first time, I would like to invite you to subscribe, and don't forget to click that little bell on the right so you will get a notification whenever I have a new video up. Thank you, and I will see you next.